to the food system at a global level. It's just a massive industry built on big volumes, on big businesses, all the way through the supply chain. So one of the global crops that really dominates today is farmed rice, and that is grown all over the world. In fact, it's grown in every continent apart from Antarctica. The main issue is that rice is responsible for more greenhouse gas emissions globally than air travel. So rice is an absolutely massive global crop, and that is the main staple for 4 billion people around the world, part of their daily diets. It's a part of culture and cuisine, and it's a massive part of food security as a result. Related to that, you think of rice as environmentally friendly plant, and suddenly it all starts to add up, and it becomes clear that actually the rice industry is responsible for a huge part of our global CO2 equivalent emissions. So that's why ultimately I started Nice Rice, is because we want to change the rice industry with a much, much better way of growing rice, better for the farmer, better for the planet. We're starting in India, which is the second biggest producer in the world. We're working with OLAM Agri, our rice supplier, a big global agribusiness. OLAM Agri recruit our farmers in India. The farmers have been trained in this sustainable rice platform standard, which has been accredited by the IPCC and the UN. There's over 40 different elements to it. Probably the main one, I think, is in terms of the methane reduction and the water saving.
So traditionally in India, our farmers are used to growing rice with continuous flooding. So this is one of the worst aspects of the way rice is grown in the country, because the water that's associated with this is also responsible for the majority of the greenhouse gas emissions. So through our projects, we promote something called alternative wetting and drying instead of continuously flooding the fields.
Where you've got a flooded field, that means there's no oxygen in the soil. That's the perfect environment for these little methane-producing microbes. And as they recreate in the soil, they produce methane.
Practicing alternative wetting and drying reduces the greenhouse gas emissions as associated with what we have seen from our data.
The benefits for the environment are long-term, obviously reduction of methane emissions, but in a shorter term, in India particularly, actually there's a huge problem with water use. The water table is dropping really fast.
पहले से ज़्यादा मानों ने 30% पानी की बचत हुई है। पानी बचने से लगा लो, अगर पानी बचेगा, तभी तो हम अपनी आने वाली पीढ़ी को कुछ देके जाएंगे। क्वालिटी भी बेहतर हुई है और उपज भी पहले से ज़्यादा हुई है। एक पैदावार अच्छी होने के कारण भी मार्केट में हमें रेट अच्छा मिला है।
Farmers love it because it's high yielding. And then the second benefit is we're paying a premium price. And then we're working with OLAM all the way through the supply chain. We've got full transparency back to the individual farmers and to know exactly what those farmers are doing. Each container that we import from India is coming from farmers who are prioritizing sustainability. So this kilo of rice here saved 3,000 liters of water at the farm and has cut 1.29 kilograms of CO2 emissions. So if you think times that by 300 units here, it does start to add up. The biggest element of the emissions is from the rice farming. The second biggest component of our emissions is from shipping. We're working with a company called Good Shipping, who are doing amazing work to try and boost the uptake of sustainable biofuels. So we are purchasing those biofuels to offset the emissions from our shipping. And then here in the UK, again, at every step, we're trying to do things as sustainably as possible. Here you can see some pallets of our ready-to-heat range. So these are all microwavable plastic pouches. This is how about half of the UK eats their rice now in these sorts of packs. We thought really long and hard about whether to use this plastic packaging and decided in the end it was the best thing for us to try and, in terms of our mission of trying to get, you know, sustainably farmed rice into as many kitchens as possible, getting those consumers on board, getting them thinking about sustainability when they're eating rice, and hopefully understanding and appreciating what we're trying to do a bit differently. You know, that bit is so important for us as a brand, and ultimately I think really important for us to be able to influence the industry. The thing that actually really excites me about this form of sustainable growing is that, like, can apply to other crops as well. It's not just rice. At a farm level, it's not a difficult process. It doesn't require expensive or complex machinery, lots more people or expertise.
This business model of sustainable production is key not just to rice cultivation. Because of population growth, we have a lot more mouths to feed. And that means that we have to produce more, but we do not necessarily have the resources to do so. The scale at which we are working is only a tiny fraction of what can actually be done. But there are a lot more players in the ecosystem who, if they come together, do have the capacity to impact change at a much larger scale.
If we can get to that point, that's when I think there'll be a kind of a step change, better food system that's basically better for everyone.